going to explore racing in GTA Online, from the different kinds of tracks to exploring the entire fleet of vehicles in the game and their performance, to most of the known tricks used in racing to beat your opponents. Before we get started with this episode, let us thank Brokey1322, Crazy Man, Shaggy, the No-Do Crew, and the guys at the GTA forums for all the time they've spent testing every vehicle, collecting data, and figuring out how things work. Their time and discoveries allows every gamer to spend their money wisely while learning a thing or two about racing. So, without any further ado, let's get down to where the rubber meets the road, so to speak, in this first episode. Tracks, your real first enemy in every racing game. A good track is always a balance between straights and corners, but when it comes to GTA Online, tracks don't respect this balance, most of the time. So the wise thing to do before joining or starting a race is to look at the track in order to understand what kind of vehicle is best to use. So permit us to make a few examples. Let's start with the Sonora Freeway. This is a point-point race with long straights and not too many corners. It's all tarmac and not a single place of off-road. So what you need here is a vehicle with the highest top speed and a fast acceleration to reach it. The best choice is the Benefactor Schaefer V12. While this car is surely not agile, it's damn fast. Vespucci Dreams is, on the other hand, a circuit full of corners. The straights are so short, no vehicle will have time to reach its top speed. On a track like this, you need good brakes, but most importantly, traction and acceleration. The faster you can take corners and gain speed, the sooner you'll reach the checkered flag. The best sport vehicle for a track of this kind is the Annus Elegy RH8. As you can see already, the fastest vehicle is not always the best choice. If we race these tracks with the opposite vehicles, our times will decrease. We'll talk more about the vehicles and their performance in another video. For now, let's get back to this episode's main topic, tracks and cars. Once you understand the performance needed from your vehicle, you need to know how to get the maximum advantage out of each car. In other words, welcome to Racing 101. First things first, brakes. This is GTA Online, not Fast and Furious. So keep your finger away from the handbrake. Sliding through corners may be a pleasure for the eyes, but racing-wise, you're just wasting time and speed. Braking is your friend, but like any friend, abuse them and they'll stop helping. Allow us now to show you the difference between abusing brakes and simply decelerating. To do so, we're going to show the use of the left and right trigger on the gamepad so you can understand exactly when and how we're using the gas and brakes. This is a sequence of corners from the track Thrills in the Hills. If you push the gas to the limit before reaching corners, you will also need to use the brakes to avoid crashing or oversteering and spin your vehicle in the wrong direction. Racing this way may look fast, but it's not. The right way to go through these corners is by dosing the gas and tapping on the brakes only when needed. As you can see, we almost haven't used the brakes at all. Then there are the other keystones of racing, lines. In racing, momentum is fundamental. In other words, you need to try keeping your speed up as much as you can while moving along the circuit, as if mimicking a fluid flowing along the track. Probably the best way to help you understand this is by taking a short race on the Vinewood racetrack. We're going to place the camera high above the circuit so you can clearly see the differences between the paths taken by the various cars. The red car keeps his speed up most of the time, using the brakes only at the end while entering inside the corner. The apex of the corner is far from the path and the car loses a lot of speed along the corner itself. The yellow car, instead, is trying to keep the speed inside the corner by moving up into it. The correct apex is missed again, and the high speed made the car crash into the external barriers. Last is the green car, that will try to follow the racing lines correctly. It stays on the outside of the track, slows down a bit before entering the corner, hits the apex correctly, and immediately pushes the gas to exit with the maximum torque the end can muster. Now, let's see how these three cars perform a single lap on the Vinewood racetrack all together. So, what we've learned so far is that circuits are different, and not always the fastest car is the best one. Brakes are an important part too, but overuse will only slow us down. Lastly, we have to move along a track, keeping a fluid movement between straights and corners. A fluid lap around the circuit is usually faster than one of rough stop and goes. These three dogmas are just the bedrock of racing in GTA Online. We have classic tracks, stunt tracks, and special vehicle tracks. And these three kinds of races require different driving techniques. For the classic category, we'll include all the circuits and point-to-point races that use the normal streets of Los Santos and Blaine County, tarmac or off-road. The main characteristics of these tracks is, most of the time, the presence of objects along the road, from light posts to trees, guardrails, etc., as well as street traffic and pedestrians. With all of these, classic races become the hardest kind of racing in GTA Online. Not only do you need to apply the tips we've explained before, but you'll also need to be very familiar with the map in order to know the risks you can take. Like in chess, you need to think one step further, like using the traffic at the intersections to your advantage, or slowing down and letting your opponent overtake you, only to use the slipstream off him while keeping him from doing the same to you. This is where our tips to help you win every classic race end. There are just too many variables to cover them all in a short video. What we can say is to not give up. With the slipstream and catch up active, it's pretty easy to get back on the podium. And even with those deactivated, it's still possible. And above all, remember, to paraphrase international champion Valentino Rossi, the doctor says, most of the time, races are won by the racer who fucks up the least, not the fastest. Avoid those racers who are clearly off their rockers. This isn't hard to do. At the beginning of a race, when starting up front, move to the inside of the corner. If you're in back, stay behind everyone. And by the first corner, you'll see half of the pack has been taken out. During the race instead, keep an eye on the mini-map to understand how many opponents you have and how near they are to you. Avoiding a dick if your opponents are racing clean, but don't let them steal your lines. But as soon as you see it's a dirty race and they're clearly trying to take you out, it's your job to give them hell, becoming the biggest SOB on the track. The community introduced stunt and professional racing tracks into GTA Online from the very start. From the jumps to Los Santos GP, the community has always added new ways to race in the game until Rockstar Games decided to add a proper stunt racing DLC, while at the same time providing creators all the instruments needed to elevate the racing aspects of the game once and for all. The main difference between classic and stunt professional circuits is the layout of the track and the props used. Even when using the normal roads of the game, stunt and professional circuits keep poles, trees, and such excluded from the path the vehicle takes. Expert drivers nail these circuits, but the newbie players who are racing for the first time are also able to understand how to drive along these tracks. Every track, or at least most of them, have one or more shortcuts. iTwister and Oleg, aka DJ Meg, two of the fastest and smartest racers in GTA Online, are references that you might want to add to your bookmarks. These guys are always hunting for shortcuts and tactics to gain seconds along the tracks, and most of the time, they share their discoveries in their videos, allowing everyone to see and use these tricks. And speaking of tricks, There are some that you can use to gain speed, like curb boosting, gliding, and more. But tricks and glitches are topics for a future episode. The last kind of racing is the special vehicle races. These tracks are similar to normal stunt racetracks, but it's the vehicle used that makes the difference. Locked to the Ruiner 2000, Rocket Voltic, and Glazer Aqua, these tracks hide many tricks that will make you a winner. First and most important, avoid airtime. Do not use the rocket of the Volt on a ramp or while flying to move forward. Hit the ramp, then point the car nose to the ground. Then turn on the rocket. This way, you'll reach ground before your opponents, gaining control of your vehicle and speed, and you'll recharge your boost before everyone else. You can use the parachute of the Ruiner 2000 in pretty much the same way in certain jumps. Once you've launched yourself over the ground, point the nose of the Ruiner down while gaining altitude, and as soon as you see platform, open the parachute. Keep it open for a moment and then close it and put the car nose to the ground again. If you nail the sequence correctly, you'll see that the parachute will give you a boost instead of slowing you down. For the long jump stead, try to understand whether you need the parachute or not. And if you feel confident in reaching the platform without using it, go for it, because that will give you a good advantage over your opponents. The last special vehicle is the Blazer Aqua. The Blazer Aqua responds to the same tricks as motorbikes, so it's different from the previous vehicles. Use airtime to your advantage and glide over long jumps to reach the next checkpoint faster. The race Surf and Turf is a perfect example of how gliding can give you a big advantage. Don't overuse this trick, however, because not every jump will pay off with a glide. In the water instead, try to keep your vehicle in the air for as little time as possible. Avoid waves, and if there is no other way to do it, lean forward in order to push the Blazer back into the sea. And that's all for now about racing in vehicles in GTA Online. In the next episode, we'll go through the entire fleet of vehicles to find the fastest, most agile, the beasts, the beauties, and more. From performance upgrades to tricks that will make your car go as fast as possible. Don't miss it. With that said, keep following us on Twitter